Moving on, care ratings, another stock to focus on. Let's quickly pull up the counter and see what the stock is doing in trade. There has been an earnings dent because the revenues are down. Profits have gone down by 28%. The other income also has been lower, and we've seen a dip in terms of margins as well. Rajesh Mokashi, MD and CEO at Care Ratings, joins us. Welcome to the show, Rajesh. What has led to this kind of a weakness this time around?
I think there are three factors which affect our results this quarter. One is that there has been some change in the revenue recognition policy in 18, and there was a spillover effect of income from 17 in 18, which does not appear in Q1 19. So if we make an adjustment for some of these, this particular aspect, the revenue growth would have been 6.7% on a standalone basis and 8.29% on a consolidated basis. The operating profit growth, the business, real business growth, profit growth, has been in the region of 2.4% and 2.76%. Now, coming to investments, which we have substantial in nature, a significant part of our investment are in fixed maturity plans. And because there is a mark-to-market requirement for these now with the Ind AS coming in, there is a small dent on that. But the FMPs are bought with a clear intent of holding them to maturity. And so in a sense, it's a technical charge rather than an actual loss suffered by the company. Of course, we have an ESOP charge coming in this year because of the ESOPs given some time back. And that also affects the results. But otherwise, on a like-to-like basis, we have an 8.29% growth rate on the top line rating operations or the operating revenues on consolidated basis, and the operating profit margin profit has grown by 2.76%.
Right. Rajesh, interestingly, as you just mentioned, with regards to the ESOP expenses as well, there is an estimate of around a 15 crore impact in FY19. Is that something that we will see?
Yeah, I think roughly 3.66 per quarter it will come to, roughly, very, very roughly. The first quarter we have seen 3.66.
Okay. Apart from that as well, do you see headwinds in the industry, at least in the medium term, as banks continue to grapple with asset quality concerns as well as hardening yields as well, that is actually affecting debt issuances?
Yeah, I think there are challenges that we are observing in terms of, if you see the crude price, the inflation, the interest rates, the PCA banks, the general anemic credit offtake, the fall in bond markets issuance in this first quarter. Some of these issues are there in the first quarter. But otherwise, if you see the GDP estimates of 7, 7.5, the monsoon reasonably being well spread out, the rural economy picking up, the consumption cycle picking up, the infra spending from the government, not private sector. So these aspects makes us believe that there could be a reasonable good growth in the demand for bonds and credit in the next three quarters. And that should augur well for the rating industry, but otherwise somewhat challenging year than a conventional year. But if you look at the medium-term prospects of the rating industry, they are purely driven by this complete bond market transformation in India. The recent SEBI guidelines or SEBI discussion paper also talks about shifting 25% of the borrowings for people borrowing more than 100 crore per 100 crore outstanding to the bond markets with AA and above ratings. So that is the real story for the rating industries in the next 3 to 5 years.
Right. So basically, is it right to say that there will be an increase in the mix towards bonds as well as CP ratings?